In today's video, I'm sharing 10 new Canva tips and tricks that you can use to become a better designer and create more engaging content. Ready? Let's do this. Hi, my lovely people, it's Natalia and welcome back to my channel where I help you create better content and grow on social media. And it's been a highly requested video after part 1 and 2 of my Canva tips and tricks, so I hope you're excited to discover some brand new Canva hacks. Some of the tips I share with you today are available for free users, while others may require a pro account. And of course, it's completely up to you if you want to use the free or the paid version, but I can tell you that Canva Pro is well worth the money with all the incredible features that come with it. You can check out the link in the description box for a free 30-day trial for Canva Pro. All right, let's jump straight to Canva. Tip number 1, time video elements. All right, let's start with an absolute banger of a tip. It has to do with the Canva video editor. Did you know that you can adjust the timing of any elements that you put on top of your footage? There's a new slightly hidden feature that lets you do it quickly from the timeline, and there's no need to split the video into multiple clips every time you add something on top of it. To do this, add an element onto your clip, just like this Instagram logo, and instead of splitting the footage from the timeline below in here to have it appear when you want it to, right-click on the element like this and click Show Timing. This will expand the element on the timeline below, and you can simply drag the sides like this to adjust the length of the element. I was so excited when this was introduced because, let's be honest, you don't want to split your clip into hundreds of pieces just to add some text or a pop-up graphic on top of it, and still not a very well-known feature since it's pretty much hidden from the timeline unless you click on the element and find this option there. Tip number 2, remove video backgrounds. This has to be one of my favorite new options in Canva. Just like with images, you can now remove backgrounds from videos too. It's such a great feature because it allows us to create a variety of fun designs in videos. You can search the library for animated green screen footage and remove the backgrounds to overlay them on top of your videos. You can create GIFs or animations of you to use within your designs. You can replicate the green screen effect that we know so well from Instagram or TikTok, or you can just use your clip and switch up the background for something completely different. There are so many great possibilities with this one cool feature. To do this, find any video from the library or upload yours. I'm going to use mine. Then select it and choose Edit Video from the top panel right here. And here's our background remover. Now let's click it and let it process. And that's your transparent video clip. And one small note for me here, as you can see, it is still in beta, so it works best with simple backgrounds, but by all means, experiment with different clips because there may be enough contrast between the subject and the background for the tool to recognize it well. And by the way, I'm launching my Canva course for beginners soon, so if you want to become a better designer and improve your business and social media with Canva, click the link in the description box and sign up on the waitlist. I can't wait to see you there. Tip number 3, create your own photo filters. It's super important to keep a consistent brand image across all of your social media platforms, your websites, and any resources or materials you create. And this applies to the photos you use too. You know how people use similar styles of editing for their photos, usually by using the same presets? Well, you can achieve something fairly similar within Canva. Granted, it's definitely not as advanced as Adobe Lightroom or VSCO, but it does the job nicely when you have to adjust something to fit the style of your design. One of my favorite tips is to use filter codes to then apply the same settings across your images. To do this, choose an image and then click Edit Image here at the top in the panel. Then from here, you'll see the Adjust tab and you can just click See All. And from here, you'll be able to adjust things like brightness, you can up the contrast, you can even make it sharper with the blur. But this particular image, I feel like needs a bit less warmth, so I can just adjust it from here. Once you have all of your adjustments, you can just go to the filter code right here, copy it, and you can select a different image, do the same exact thing. So edit image at the top, go to adjust and see all, and at the bottom, you can paste your code. It's a very useful trick to keep your images consistent and make your designs look a little bit more polished. Tip number 4, enhance your photos. We also have 3 new effects to improve our images. We have face retouch, auto enhance, and auto focus. Now to access them, select a photo, go back to edit image at the top, scroll down, and you'll actually be able to either see them here within the tools if they were used before, or you may be able to find them here in the you may also like section. So let's start with autofocus. When you click on it, it basically identifies the subject of your image and blurs the background to an extent to create this look that professional lenses would give you. You can then adjust the blur position from here with the slider or the intensity like this as well. I highly recommend you play around with the sliders just to make sure you're achieving this balanced look. Next, we have Auto Enhance, and this is simply a one-click filter that improves your parameters of the image. It balances all the different settings like brightness, clarity, contrast, just to make your photo look better. With one click, it analyzes the photo and applies an automatic setting to improve it, and you can then adjust the intensity, again with a slider, and toggle the original to see the changes. Last but not least is the face retouch from here. When you choose this option, it automatically applies some filters to the photo to kind of enhance the look by whitening teeth, by smoothing the skin, and removing the red eye effect if it exists. And with the auto option, you can adjust the intensity on the slider again, but you don't have to go for the automatic settings. You can actually select the skin smoothing, the whitening of teeth, you can have the red eye effect on its own and change the intensity from there for a more targeted effect. A little disclaimer here, I'm not a fan of intense retouching because it really affects how we perceive reality and our self-image, so I don't recommend going too heavy with this, but I can understand how this can be useful if you're enhancing photos to have a more editorial feel. And a heads up as well, all three of these tools are in beta, so I expect them to keep on getting better with time. Tip number 5, apply video adjustments. All right, we've covered photo filters, but do you know you can also do something similar to your videos? Well, first of all, Canva has its own filters for you, so you can make your footage look a bit better or match it to the style of your photos. Secondly, just like with photos, you can now also adjust the visual aspects of your videos and again, make them brighter, darker, you can make them warmer, colder, you get the drill. To do this, select the clip you want and hit edit video in the top panel again, and similarly to photos, you'll see the adjustments, but they're in the second tab right here at the top. The layout is slightly different here. Unfortunately, this panel doesn't allow us to copy unique filter codes. Hopefully, that's a feature that Canva is working on, but it's still very useful with all the different sliders here. If you want to apply Canva's filters, you can go to the first tab right here, and just below our background remover, you have all the filters. If you click see all, you'll be able to apply something, and once you apply it, you can just change the intensity. Maybe let's go for something like this. You see the differences. And then if you want to remove that filter, you can just go back to none. Tip number 6, batch create social media posts. Did you know you have the possibility to quickly create a bunch of posts for different platforms with just a few clicks using the same template? If you didn't, then I hope you're excited. It's called Quick Create, and it's a really great feature for all of us content creators who want to save some precious time. Now, Quick Create is not so obvious and can be easily missed. What you need to do is to go to your homepage and choose the social media tab here below the search bar. Now, once you click on it, that's going to be your first choice from the popular tab, and once you click on it, then you're welcomed by a new type of editor which lets us quickly design a bunch of graphics for Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, LinkedIn, and even email. Once you select what you want, you can then add your primary and secondary text. You can move along to an image and a logo. And next, you can select a template from this library right here, and then select your own color palette and apply your own fonts to keep a consistent brand image. And if you keep on clicking on the palettes, the colors are going to shuffle and you'll see a lot more variety so that you end up with a well-matched design. When you're done, you can just click finish, wait for the images to be processed, and then download a whole pack of your new designs ready to be uploaded across all platforms. Just a neat little trick that can easily be missed among all the other Canva features. Tip number 7, draw your own elements. Okay, heads up because not everyone knows about this. You can draw in Canva right within the editor and straight into your designs. This trick is very cool for those moments when you really need a custom element that you can't seem to find in the library. To be able to draw, scroll down in the left panel here to the More tab and then type draw in the search bar. Now you should be able to see the icon for the draw tool, and once you select it, you can choose between a few different effects. We have the standard pen here, we have the marker, then the glow pen, and a highlighter. And as usual, you can adjust the sliders to change the size, or in this case, the transparency as well, and choose the color too. Once you draw something, another icon appears for the eraser to be able to fix any mistakes. And the great thing is that when you're done drawing, you can click done from the top panel here, and your drawing becomes an element just like any other from the Canva library. You can move it, you can rotate it, you can make it bigger or smaller. Basically, you can incorporate it into your design however you please. This is another beta feature, so it's going to be improved over time, and I definitely feel like this is one of those options that works so much better with a graphic tablet for the best control, but you can still use it with a mouse or a touchpad if you're especially dexterous. Tip number 8, export in CMYK. For all of you lovely people designing in Canva with the intention of actually printing designs later, you can export your designs in CMYK. CMYK is a color model used in color printing, and it stands for 4 ink plates: cyan, magenta, yellow, and key. It's super important for the printing process so that your colors are rendered correctly and look the same way both in the editor and in real life. Heads up straight away, this is a Canva Pro option, so you won't be able to access it if you have a free account. Now, to export your designs in CMYK, go to Share, then to Download, and in the file type, choose PDF Print for the best quality possible, and then select CMYK in the color profile. It defaults to RGB, so you can choose CMYK from here. And as a useful side note here, you can also select to include crop marks in here, you can flatten PDF and include notes, all of which are usually a necessity when using professional printing services. And by the way, if you go to File here in the top right corner, you can select Show Margins and Show Bleed to see the parameters of your design. Now, bleed is the extra space around the outside of your design that gets trimmed when printed, and is absolutely crucial in printing pretty much anything from business cards, leaflets, folders, to banners and posters. Usually, print shops require a 3mm bleed, and this is why you need to include it in your design. Same goes for margins. It's crucial to have enough negative space on the inside so that no important elements or text get accidentally snipped off. Tip number 9, design presentations quickly with layouts. It's no surprise that Canva helps you create incredible presentations, and I've shared some really useful tips for those in part 1 of this video. It's going to be linked, so make sure you check it out next. But there's more to presentations. Apart from using some of the templates that Canva provides, you can now access a variety of presentation layouts too. To do this, choose any presentation, it can be blank or not, and once you're in the editor, tap the templates tab in the top left panel. Just as I've said, apart from the templates bar, you also have the layouts here, and you can apply any layout to your presentation with one click. Now, if you've used a blank presentation, you have standard branding here, but if you've chosen a template, you'll see that all the styles are applied for you too, so you keep your slides consistent with the fonts. If you want to finesse it even more, you can go to your chosen template right here, and then at the bottom, you can apply your template style. If you keep on clicking on it, you'll see the different colors to add even more interest to your slides. I absolutely love that Canva keeps on improving all the existing features apart from adding new ones, and the presentations are no exception here. Tip number 10, learn with Canva Events. I want to put you up to something that a lot of people miss out on. Apart from obviously being a very versatile design and editing tool, Canva is a brilliant way to learn new things, and Canva Events let you do that. They're not really advertised that much, so I consider them to be a bit of a hidden gem. There's always something on covering a variety of different subjects. It can view past events as well. You can even get a wee certificate of completion after you've participated in the event. And to access Canva Events, you can simply go to canva.com/events. And from here, you'll be able to see what's going on and sign up for a class. Have you discovered something new today? Go to the comment section and share your favorite tip you've learned from this video. Now, I have a bunch of other Canva tips and tricks to make you a better designer and speed up your workflow, so make sure you watch part 2 now. And of course, if you're more serious about mastering Canva and using it for social media and your business, make sure to sign up on the waitlist for my upcoming Canva course. Subscribe for more exciting Canva tutorials and content marketing tips, and like this video if you've enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.